In this video, I'm going to teach you the easiest way to remember ABGs and to get them right on your nursing school exams. Hey friend, I'm Christina Raffano from nursingschoolofsuccess.com and you are watching The Nursing School Show, where we give you the tips and the resources that you need to totally own nursing school. And today we are talking about a topic that so many nursing students struggle with. It's one of the biggest questions I get. How to learn and remember arterial blood gas interpretation, or ABGs for short. Seriously, this is a topic that so many nursing students struggle with, and I bet you can relate. I was right there with you, totally. So today I'm going to walk you through three simple and kind of fun questions to ask to get ABGs right every single time in nursing school. And be sure to watch all the way until the end of this video, because of course I have a free cheat sheet for you that will help you to remember all of this. So let's do it. So when you think of ABGs, I want you to think about one big party. Yes, think about ABGs like a huge, huge party. But it's a mystery party, and there are three things that you need to figure out at this mystery party. So we'll give you the three questions here first, and then we'll walk through each one. So the first question that you'll need to ask is, where is this party happening? Where is the ABG party going down? Now the second question you'll ask is, who is the party pooper? Yep, you need to figure out who the party pooper is. And finally, the third question you'll ask is the life of the party helping to make the party better? Or is the life of the party just being kind of lame and letting the party pooper bring everybody down? So those are the three questions that you'll need to ask about this ABG mystery party. So now let's walk through each one of these questions. So our first question is, where is this ABG party happening? Now there are two choices. The party is either happening at some rundown, creepy warehouse, and it's a party where everybody be straight up tripping on some acid, or it's at a nightclub and it's all about that bass. See what I did there? So to figure out where this party is happening, you need to look at the pH level and decide where the party is going down. Is it an acid party or is it a base party? So look at the pH level, and if the pH level is less than 7.4, you know the party is an acid party and it's in some creepy warehouse somewhere. If the pH is greater than 7.4, you know that it's a base party and it's in some fancy nightclub. Now, when you figure out where the party is located, you need to ask yourself the second question. Who is the party pooper? Who is making this party just no fun at all? So there are two choices here as well. Either the lungs are the party poopers, or the kidneys are the party poopers. Now for this, you'll need to look at the PaCO2 level, which represents the lungs, and the HCO3 level, which represents the kidneys. So normal PaCO2 is between 35 to 45 milliliters mercury, and normal HCO3 is between 22 to 26 milliequivalents per liter. If the pH is acidic and the PaCO2 is higher than normal, that means that the lungs are bringing way too much acid to the party, and they are the party poopers. Now, if the pH is basic and the HCO3 level is higher than normal, then that means the kidneys got way too carried away with all that base, and they are the party poopers. So you need to figure out who the party pooper is. Look at the PaCO2 and the HCO3 levels and decide who the party pooper is. Is it the lungs or is it the kidneys? Now that you've got that figured out, you need to ask yourself the third and final question. Is the life of the party, meaning the non-party pooper, trying to help make the party better? So, let's say that the lungs are the party poopers, but the HCO3 value is still within normal range. Well, then the kidneys haven't noticed that the lungs are being the party poopers, but they aren't doing anything to make the party more fun. But if the HCO3 level is starting to increase, that means that the kidneys did notice. They said, oh man, this party is getting a little dull. We need to turn up the bass. And if the kidneys are the party poopers, but the PaCO2 level is normal, then the lungs haven't done anything to help their party out. But if the PaCO2 level is starting to increase, then the lungs are trying to add a little more acid to the party and get everyone to be having a better time. So there are your three questions to ask. Where is the ABG party located? Who is the party pooper? Is it the lungs or is it the kidneys? And is the life of the party trying to help? Now, let's talk about compensated versus uncompensated ABG values. Uncompensated means that the life of the party hasn't noticed that anything is wrong. Its value is still within normal range and the pH is still messed up. Partially compensated means that the life of the party has noticed that the party pooper is being, well, a party pooper, but they haven't had enough time to make the party fun again. The pH is still out of whack, even though the life of the party's value is changing to try to compensate. Now, full compensation happens when the life of the party has done their job well. Their value has changed and the pH has gone back within normal range. All right, so let's walk through an example here. Let's say that we have a patient whose lab values are a pH of 7.33, a PaCO2 of 55, and an HCO3 of 26. Now let's walk through our questions. Where is this party happening? Well, the pH is acidic because it's less than 7.4, so the party is at some rundown creepy warehouse. So we know that the problem is too much acid, so we're dealing with acidosis. Now, who is the party pooper? The PaCO2 value is way too high, so the lungs are being super duper party poopers. So we know the problem is respiratory, and the lungs are the party poopers. Number three, is the life of the party helping to make the party better? Well, the HCO3 value is still within normal range, so the kidneys haven't noticed that the lungs are raining on everybody's parade. So the life of the party hasn't noticed and the pH is still messed up, so we know that it is uncompensated. So this example is uncompensated respiratory acidosis. If you want a free cheat sheet to help you out with ABGs in nursing school, just click the link in the description below. I'll put a link there and I'll send it right to you. So if you like this video, let me know. Hit the like button below, share it with your friends, and be sure to click subscribe and hit that bell so you never miss a video. Thanks for watching, friend. Now go become the nurse that God created only you to be. And I will catch you next time on the Nursing School Show.